Hello and welcome back, dear friends. It's me, Odo, and we are back in our campaign of EU4 with Sweden showing that we are not overpowered. We do some stuff for Poland as he's now at war with Hungary, but Hungary is also at war with Venice. Are you at war in two? Yeah, you're in two wars. That's too bad for you. And France is just helping you against Poland. And they are not really helping. I mean, there is no French army around. And we are at the war together with Austria, with these guys. I really don't know what goes on there, because I really don't care. I just care that Poland is paying me nearly 20 ducats a month for this army that is literally doing virtually doing more or less nothing. They just stand there and wait until the siege is done. And they will not engage in any fight at all. Next they will try to get Krakow after they've released Warsaw. And I hope these guys are so small down here that they won't attack us. A 10 navy tradition, that's nice. What's that? To everlasting friendship. Local unrest minus 3, yeah, that's okay. Ooh, Gustav Adolf, that's a good heir. 444, I mean, he's much better than the one before. But his mother's quite stupid, so yeah. We hope that his father lives long enough until he's 15 or so. Wait, what? They made peace. Ugh. That's not good, because then our troops are obsolete. We should go away from there, because there is Did they lose Przemyśl? And Novi Sad and Krakow, really? That's good. That's really good. Also, this war ends. No, with Milan it ended. I hope he pays me. He pays on. For my army. Because he's paying really good for that. Although he has no war. Interesting. So my plan in getting Austria to fight these guys later on to fight Brandenburg won't work anyway. Too bad. They want to marry us, but we don't want to marry you, Poland. Really. Because we probably want to fight you in the near future. But we will probably build another fort up there. Like in Westerbotten. There is also Bergslagen. We should also build a fort here. Here in Westerbotten. First in Bergslagen, because this is near my capital. We can protect the capital. Yeah, whatever. He probably wants me to fight his stupid rebels, but I really don't care about his rebels. How about my ships? Should we build more ships? At least one more. How's my trade going? We control 64% in our home node. Yay! There are even more rebels. That's good. Aragon occupied Skane? Really? Why would you do this? Stupid Aragonese. Guy, let's get to move, boy. This is terrible. Go away, stupid Aragon. Leave my lands in peace. Just die. Not allowed for you to come here. Cavalry cost is down as well. So we even got participation now. Protecting my land. fork down here as well. Corner. Or Guinge. Let's build it in Guinge. Let's kill this 3,000 men as well. I mean, why are they here anyway? Go away and die. You come here. Admiral died. Probably should get a new one. Let's see. Admiral gives us 20 influence. That's 91. Yeah, that's okay. Let's ask for money. Let's ask for ticket points. Let's give the money to them. Ooh. We probably should give the nobles some land. Like some grain provinces. Do we have some grain provinces? Yeah, there are two. There is one. No grain here. Let's grant this generalship and let's recruit a minister and let's demand military points. Ah, stop, 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 stop. Würzburg. Where is Würzburg? Augsburg. Memmingen. Hessen. Where is Würzburg? Ah, there is Würzburg. Switzerland next. I mean, why not? Why not get a claim on everyone around here? We are still in this war, aren't we? Yeah. They still pay my troops in Poland. This is so great. These are forks as well. This explains everything. I was just wondering why they still are not reoccupied. So now we build a spy network on Austria and we are improving relations with them. Let's boost it 2 times to get positive there again. Okay, we could side with the burghers, giving them loyalty and losing loyalty with the clergy, or the other way around. We want the burghers to be loyal because we will probably do some development after the diplo points are up to 999 points. So let's do it like that. No, this was stupid, I believe, because we probably are now having them. Oh no, they're not even over 100%. But we should take care of these as this as well. So are you building? Yeah, you're building a castle there. So there is only one place for a castle left, and that's Westerbotten. Let's build a castle here as well. And then my country is protected rather well. So, regional conscription, Swedish military reforms until the end of the game. Morale of army +5%, infantry cost -10%, that's good. Mercenary is stupid, naval expansion, heavy ship, nah. Regional conscription, that's great, that makes my army even less expensive. I think the game is broken because Poland is still paying for my army there. I mean, it's probably because of these rebels. They are quite fearsome. Oh no, a looming disaster, of course. I thought so. You're at 101%. So, when do these stop? 1509 is the earliest. Yeah, so we have to revoke some land from them. Like this province, it's a grain province. No. Why do the Burgers have this province? There is a center of trade. It's a natural harbor. We don't have centers of trade. We can't upgrade them. I don't have the DLC for that. So probably in Nerke. Or in Elfsborg. Yeah, probably here. We probably should do some development first. Where's the development cost? Nuland. Narva is somewhere around here as well. Or probably not. Where's Narva? There is Narva. Ah, what did I do? No! Take it back! Oh. So, let's do it like that. And now let's Let's piss them off. Bribes growing more accepted. Ugh. Don't accept bribes. The rest of the world shall tremble at the sound of our might, and the glory of Sweden shall soar above the horizon far and wide. We are now a great power. Yay. That's nice. So we didn't have to do anything with this war anyway. We are winning it even without doing anything. And we are getting paid from Poland for an army that just stands around. It was a good idea to do some sieges. Root out corruption, minus 13.9. That's really a lot. I hope these rebels won't go away too fast. I hope we can root out corruption before. Hey, our truce with these stupid guys extended. I'm not sure. Probably we can attack them, ask Poland to help us in the war, and we probably keep the condottieri on their side. Will this probably work? I don't think so. Fine, and we don't have a war anymore. Just took Ostroda. Really? What's that? Genoa wants military access? How about we declare war on you? Ugh, Muscovy would help them. No, I don't want Muscovy to help them. I don't care about Denmark, they could help. But I don't want Muscovy to help. So we'll have to do it again like this. Attacking Denmark, getting Livonian Order in the war. So we'll have to wait another few years. But it doesn't matter, really. We've got time. Especially if Poland still pays for our troops. Have to build buildings now. Yeah, that's nice. At this time, especially. Stop. Let's take the claim here. Let's come back home. Let's build a spy network on you. Austria still defends him, of course. Would he also defend Verden? Most probably, yeah.
Can't you just do anything else? Like,
doing some war with someone else? Why didn't you get enough? Yeah, you have enough. Poland is in debt. Really, really highly in debt. Could this be because you're paying for troops you don't use? I mean, ugh. An advisor, we gain a claim. We build more spy networks. Could try to get a claim here on Provence. To get down here to attack the stupid Venetians. Oh wait, probably the Venetians would work. Should get a new advisor. Do we have a half price advisor here? Improve relations, trade efficiency, improve relations. My man. We have some half price guys here as well. How do we see if these are half price or not? This was clearly half price. No, no half price here. This guy would be nice if he would be a bit less expensive. I mean, at the time we could afford him, but no, why not? We can afford him and we don't want the inflation. Oh. I see my inflation is going down anyway. Austria, why don't you help? You are such a grievance. I really want you to fight for me this war. Still Muscovy there, yeah. How about you? We can declare war on you as well. Interesting. This will also help. Probably it's better to do this war with them because it's easier for us to get this conquest stuff things instead of the Danish ones. Also, we want to do it anyway. Force limit is up to 41. So could afford also another cannon. Oh, probably two cannons. For now we took five. Mm-hmm. 37 to 41 is just four. Where did we build them? I really can't do with them anymore. Yay. Need a fire. So shock, fire and siege. Poland is fighting with these rebels. So another H bonus, cavalry. Colonies, improved war taxes, or feudal de jure law. Let's take the war taxes. didn't do anything the last 10 years. Ugh. Hessen lost some land to Cleves. Oh, there is no Hessen. Phew. Why is it still working? Because they are at peace. At an internal peace. Just not defend him. Even with the reconquest. With whom would we fight? Elsass, Augsburg, Brandenburg, Palatinate, Genoa, plus Verden and Anhalt and stupid England and Poland won't get into the war. I really want this war with Brandenburg done before they get even stronger. I mean, ugh, look at that. They're so strong already. Muscovy, how many reasons do you have? Oh, you are also in debt. Quite a lot, even. With some luck. Why are you in debt? I mean, what are you doing? You are not at war at all. I mean, we could spy on Muscovy as well. They deserve this. Why not? We're so friendly now towards them. Ah, now they're attacking them. France declared war upon Aragon. I fear my Condottieri contract is soon over. Oh, is it over? Nope. It's still not over. Why don't I get this? Is broken. Nope. I want to build some buildings. they are disappointed. Why? Okay. Then just revoke the contract. This is stupid. If we don't revoke them, it could be that wants my condottieri anymore. So we are black flagged, so probably we could rent them out to someone else. Austria, you've got a war? Nope. Hungary's got a war. How about you? Are you interested in lending my troops? Interested in lending my troops? No. Ah, of course not. You are a rival. But it would be great. With whom are you at war? With Hungary and Moldavia? Moldavia, can you afford troops? No, because you are a subject nation of Hungary. Interesting.
Hungary has subjects.
Hungary even just looks big, really big. Do they own this at the start of the game? No, this is Wallachia. Current wars. Castile is doing a war. And France. Aragon is probably interested in getting troops. Or Navarra. Probably not. He would take it for 73 ducats. That's not much, but at least it's something. Let's see, with whom are you allied? And who's in this war with you? Naples. Yeah, but Naples is not able to get condottieri. Papal States. Ooh, much better. 209. Much, much better. Yeah, let's lend it to him. I don't want to look around for better partners getting it. It's not as good as a contract with Poland, but it's okay. And we could use this black flagged status to go back to our land. Like here. mean this war will be over soon. After Castile is getting this fort, and it's at 71%. Verdunwants wait a bit. Verdun is at war. Are they attacking Bohemia, or are they attack against Lüneburg and then Brandenburgian reconquest of Hanover? Probably it's time to declare war on Austria. Stupidly, we rented out this army to the Pope just in time. Really, who needs Austria anyway? It's Austria anyway. If we are already at war with Austria, he wouldn't defend him either. So if we would have a war fighting Austria, that is easier for us. Or even so, he's the emperor, he's protecting everyone in the empire. Are there any wars that we could start that Poland would come to our help, or Great Britain? Like somewhere around here.
Well, like here. Yeah,
I would look at that, but only outside my installment. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. Sleep well and good night. Bye.